Hey folks, in this video I show you how I repaired my RX 100 Mark III, which got a pretty hard hit from a car door. So this camera is having a problem that it got a dent in this outer ring and the outer shutter now can't move anymore. So what I have to do is I have to pull off this top cylinder, and in order to do so I built this little tool here which I use to clamp this cylinder, and then I did the counterpart for this, which will basically push onto the lens in the middle. And since adhesive glue is used to secure the cylinder on the outer shutter, my hope is that by just giving it some force and a lot of time and maybe some heat, this glue will become soft and that I can take off the cylinder, correct it and put it back in place. So that's the plan, and let's see how it goes. Okay, so I clamped the ring here on the lens, and the plan is, and I tighten it with this screw here, and now the plan is to take this counterpart here, put some filz on top of this so that I don't damage the lens, put it on here. And when I have nuts built into this little thing, can you see it? Yeah. And then I tighten these three nuts, and so that I apply force downwards to the lens, trying to move the cylinder up. So, and this is how the whole thing looks like on the camera. So here I have my clamped tool. And I have my three screws, and all I do now is every hour or so I tighten the screw so that the load is distributed evenly. Yeah. And then I just sit and wait. Actually, maybe you can hear it, but things are moving forward pretty fast, and as you see here, I got already the first 2 millimeter or so. The cylinder comes out, so it's fairly easy. Okay, this was actually pretty easy. So it took maybe a minute or two, and then all by itself the tool lifted the cylinder. As you can see, it's just this adhesive glue here which is used to hold this together. And the nice thing is that the outer shutter is still working. So all I need to do now is I need to make sure that the cylinder here is flattened again. And that's my next task to do. So, if I look from the side and I rotate this, then I can see that right here is the dent which pushed on the outer shutter. See all around here? The border here is nicely and straight, and when I come now here, here's the dent. Okay, it's less than a millimeter, but it still has to go up a little bit. This is really very, very thin metal. And now the task is to get it just right. Not to overdo it. Yeah, this is extremely thin. This is like, it's like a tin can. It's really, really thin. So this here is how it's supposed to look. And if I turn it to the damaged place, then it looks like this. So it's a fraction of a millimeter, but still it's enough to clamp the outer shutter. All right, so it should look like this. Okay, and once we get to a damaged area, looks like that. Not easy. If you apply pressure on this very thin metal, then you can see easily, like here, you make things worse. You bring additional dents in. So what I'm doing now is I design a little part. Oops. Design a little part. Which will only apply with this little corner here pressure, and it will apply this pressure all around at the same time. Okay, and with this thing here, I will simply push into the cylinder, hoping by bending the entire thing here that everything will smoothly and evenly come out. So once you have sliced the whole thing, you will see that the really working part is basically just these three layers. This is what will push in the metal on this entire tool here. But still, it's 0.6 millimeter. And if it works, then I got my camera back. Give it a try. Okay, and this is a little cylinder, which will help me to bend the metal thing back. So the plan is to, hang on, make it sharp. Yeah. Put this thing here. Oh, actually, there's a metal plate, which has a thread in it, 5 millimeter, I believe, or four. So I put this thing here. I take my bending tool, put it in, take the screw. Screw it in. And when I apply little force, take it off, check how much it was bent, and so on and so forth until hopefully I get a result which is usable. So what happened is that the dent here, which used to be outside, going to the inside, now goes to the outside. So, and the metal is simply messed up in this region, but instead of pushing down onto the outer shades, it's now warping outside and hopefully not causing any trouble anymore. So the next step is to take this thing and to glue it back in place on the camera. Okay, and now the moment of truth. There's one button. One button is here. Will the outer shades open or not? They open. They close. They open. And they close. So, yep. Repair was successful. So all it took was basically building this little set of tools, this ring to clamp the whole thing, this, well, stabler stamp, whatever, and then this here to bend the metal back in shape. Problem solved. So, I'm so glad the repair came out this nicely. The shader opens and closes, and now the camera is ready to go again.